Yo guys, it's slyroh. You already know that today I'm going to be bringing you a fun little video where I'm going to be ranking the characters of Boyfriend Dungeon. I really enjoyed this game, and I've gone back and forth as to whether I wanted to make any sort of ranking, and I wasn't going to because it was literally going to hurt my soul to try and rank the weapons and tell you that one of them is like the worst and try and find anything bad to say about any of them, and that would have hurt my soul, but I decided to look and see if there's any tier lists, and you know, I thought it would be a pretty good idea if we include a lot of the other characters, then you can see that they're all the main weapons characters that you get to interact with are like good by comparison, and I don't know, I feel like having all the characters is going to make this a well-rounded list, so I decided to do this anyway. I had a lot of fun with this game. I did a playthrough on my channel. If you haven't watched it, I absolutely recommend go check it out, and make sure to hit the subscribe button if you have not done so already, because most of the people that watch my videos do not subscribe. So subscribing would help me so much. And I don't have anything else to say. Let's go ahead and get right on to this list. Obviously, we have all of the weapons here, and then we have the other side characters here. And I don't know who this last one is supposed to be. My guess is it might be the mom character, because I'm trying to think of who interacts with you that doesn't have like a portrait. That could be the mom character. It could be someone else, I don't know. If it's the mom character, I'm gonna throw in like B maybe. It's just like, yeah, she's supportive, but she's also a little overbearing. So there's that. Characters that we can also just throw in here, like Vitas Varnas, who cares? Like who cares? He didn't do anything. At least in my experience with the game, I don't know if he's supposed to do anything more, but like he shows up, he runs a monster shop, but he's fine. There's nothing bad, but like who cares? Who cares? Alright, let's go ahead, and we're gonna alternate between non-weapons and weapon characters. Let's go with somebody that, I enjoy a lot. Let's go with Isaac. Isaac is an S tier for me. I thought Isaac was really good. Obviously, he's the first one that you meet. He teaches you how to sort of wield a blade, and his arc of kind of overcoming, how his father is treating him was really nice and well done. He's attractive, he's got like a really nice voice, and I'm mostly just basing this off of personality. I'm not really basing it off of the weapons or how they work, because the S-Stock is actually probably one of my least favorite weapons to use. So I didn't really enjoy using it that much, but Isaac as a character, top tier for sure, but not my favorite. But while we're on the subject of Isaac, we can go ahead and talk about Vincent. Vincent sucks, right? Like, he sucks. People who don't support their children, they suck. That's all I have to say about that. And yeah, he basically... I don't think he got any sort of redemption. The Isaac's redemption story was that he just wasn't feeling controlled by his father anymore. His father basically just, like, kicked him out of his own company. He was just like, alright, bye. Like, you're a disappointment. So, yeah. Probably, I'm actually gonna say worst character in the game. You might be saying, oh, but what about Eric? Eric is, like, the worst character in the game, right? And, like, yes? So, like, I don't know. I'm not here to judge, like, what's worse. Making the life of your child, like, miserable and awful, or like stalking people and kidnapping them and stuffing them in dungeons. You know, it's like he's probably worse, right? But Eric does serve the role as like the main sort of antagonist in the game, and he does have go through his own personal journey of learning not to be a creep. So for what he brings to the game, I'm actually just gonna bump him up to C, because I appreciate what he brings to the game even if I don't like him personally. He was obviously annoying. He was also very, like, clingy and jealous and things like that, but that was, you know, technically a character flaw that he was working to overcome, at least, so that's at least better than Vincent, so I will, put him up here. Oh, no! No, I thought this tier list had... I should have added him. I don't have him. I was gonna put Jonah. Jonah is the other D-tier character for me, because the game promised me, of a character that could turn into an axe, and then they never gave me an axe to wield, so... That made me really upset, and Jonah would be a D just for that, even though he did nothing wrong. Jonah is just kind of like someone who doesn't talk that much and is a little shy and awkward and would otherwise probably be like B or C, but because the game gave me a promise of wielding an axe and didn't do that, just know that I don't have him on this tier list. I should have gotten an image and done that, but I don't feel like putting through all that effort right now, so that would be a D tier. But we did get something pretty close to an axe. We did get a scythe, which is really cool. And that's going to lead me to Rowan, who I'm actually going to put in A. Rowan, the main problem with them is that I didn't meet them until so late in the game. I basically sped ran an entire friendship slash relationship in the span of like 2 hours, maybe. It might have been maybe 3 hours, but it wasn't that long. And I love Crowley, and Crowley's great. Rowan's great. They have like a really interesting way of speaking and not really grasping just a lot of like things that are normal. I don't know. They're very eccentric in a really interesting way, but I like their fashion choice, the like purple robe thing. Oh, so good. So good. But yeah, they bring an interesting thing but to the table. But it just didn't have the same amount of time to develop as some of the other characters. So for that, they are going to have to settle into a tier. I don't know who to jump to next. We'll throw another one in S. I mean, Pocket's a cat. I love cats, and the fact that you got to go on dates with a cat is really funny. And there's really not much more to it. Pocket didn't really have like his own full character arc. I love the interactions with Pocket's owner, because it's just like, hey, imagine texting somebody and being like, hey, can I hang out with your cat? And then the owner's like, yeah, sure, I'm gonna let him outside. And then you just go hang out with someone's cat just like multiple times, and then every time you hang out with him, he comes home like it scratches or in a weird mood, and we still got to hang out with him. But at the end, Pocket was still super super great. I love Pocket a lot. Let's go. You know what, this is, what's her name, Christina? I'm gonna put her in C, if that's even her name, but I'm pretty sure that's her name. She was like a little bit rude to us, but also from her perspective, she had a chance to inherit a lot of money and just kind of took it. So like, respect, I guess. And she wasn't as outwardly rude, but like, she's kind of rude. And I would put her there. I don't know that I see any other C tier characters. Olivia's kind of close. I want to put Olivia on B just because I like her design and I like her energy. Like when you meet her, I don't think I laughed as hard as when she, like, greeted us being like, oh, what was it? She was like, Purr, welcome to, or no, she was like, welcome to Paradise Lost, or whatever. My name's Olivia, and I was like, oh, that was so good. She loves cats, I love cats. She's a bit obsessed with Blade Generation and whatnot, and can become a little bit creepy, but, like, I don't know, she didn't take those steps to actually do anything creepy, so, like, it's probably fine, so I'll let her slide in B tier for now. Speaking of Blade Generation, let's go ahead and we'll knock this out of the way. Seven is my favorite character of the game. I think he is just so good. I love his story of having to deal with, his own wants and desires versus the wants and desires of his agent and things like that and the people around him. I love that he ended up getting a supportive bandmate, in Sungwoo. I thought that was really nice. And then he just kind of went off solo. I like that his like sort of hobby of like watching mystery series, and then he shares that with us, then he writes a song about us, and man, that was so good. And I like I said, I wasn't taking weapons into account, but the laser saber is probably like my favorite weapon in the game. I love being able to just stun a bunch of enemies. I gotta say the brass knuckles are also high tier. That was a really good weapon. The scythe is probably like material. I think it was pretty good, but I didn't get a lot of practice with it. I thought it was fine. All right, we got three non-weapons, three weapons, and I think all of these characters are going to end up being, like, kind of high-ish tier. Jake also kind of goes in the middle of, like, C and B. I think I'll put him in B just because, like, I didn't really have a problem with him. Like, obviously, he comes off as, like, he's... I don't know. He comes off a lot more, like, angry and, like, bitter and, like, whatever, and jealous than he is. He's just, like, involved in, like, the Roses of Venus with Valeria, so, like... I don't know, I get it. I do kind of judge him a little bit for dating the same woman that his sister was, like, at the same time. It's a bit of a weird thing, and weirder on this side than it is for the Valeria side, but, you know, there's that. Speaking of Valeria, I feel like, Valeria's, like, teetering right on the edge, but I think I am going to put her into S tier. I really like her sort of, like, she is kind of, like, anti, like, government control. She just, like, wants the people to, like, have, like, the freedom to, like, express the things that they want. And a lot of those mentalities I can get behind. I maybe wouldn't take it as far as to go out graffitiing public property or whatever. But a lot of the things that she stands for is cool. I love her design. Her fashion sense as well was really good. And, yeah, I thought she was really great. The dagger was also a really good weapon. Again, not really factoring that in, but just a note, I thought the dagger was really cool. A tier is actually looking a little empty. So you know what? I'll throw Jesse there. Jesse's a good cousin. He supports us along the way. He's the first character we meet. He introduces us to like everybody else we meet, or at least a few people. He introduces us to Isaac, and that's how we kind of meet a lot of other people. He does introduce us to Eric, though, so, you know, I guess I should take points away from him for that. But he tries his best. I liked that he was always supportive, and he was just really cool. The main thing I really liked, his most, like, supportive moment was when he would stay on the, he stayed on the couch for us when we basically got attacked, and he was just being really supportive. He was just like, yeah, I would do that for you. And I don't know. I think Jesse's a really good character. I'll put Mandy in B. Mandy also just gives off a really cool presence. I would actually probably put her at the top of B though. If we're ranking them in order. Just because she gives off like a really cool like presence, just like the way she speaks, the way she talks, the way she just like treats people around her. It's just really cool. I don't know. She does try to give us a heads up about Sunder and what Sunder is up to, but you know, I don't know. I thought she was cool. I don't really have much more to say than she was cool. Speaking of Sunder, I'll put Sunder in A tier, above Jesse, above Rowan. I don't know. Like a part of me does. I thought it was wild that they actually went full like Sunder's a vampire. And that was literally his whole thing. Is that he is a vampire, he is going to live, like, forever, and there's a whole lot of challenges that come along with that, but it was, I don't know, it was fun while it lasted. He really was, like, you know, kind of playing with us, very flirty, very, like, into us, and then he was the one to be like, no, we shouldn't do this, things like that. So, I do like Sunder, but the story with him did take a little bit of weird turns here and there that it's just like, I don't know. And then that leaves us with Sawyer, who I think is also going to go into A tier. I don't know if they belong at, like, the bottom of the weapons, but, oh, is that really what my list would have looked like if I did, like, 7-1 my weapons? I don't know, I'll leave it there for now. Sawyer's definitely an A tier character. I love how frantic they are. The one thing is, I mentioned it when I was playing the game, is they give off such a big, like, sibling energy that, like, it's hard to really see them as, like, a romantic partner from, like, the sense of, like, playing the game. But their experiments in cooking are always very interesting. You know, they're just trying to find their way in the world and just learn things and trying to get through school. And, you know, I'm sure stuff like that is relatable to a lot of people. It didn't super connect with me, but I always had a lot of fun hanging out with them. I thought it was really, really fun. So, yeah, I think this looks good as a character tier list. I think, you know, there's a lot of good characters in this game. And I don't think I would change any of them. I could probably maybe bump Jake down to C. I mean, I could see an argument for either Eric or Christina going down to D, but I feel like I've made my case as to why Vincent's the worst character, and then, like, the rest are good. I don't know. I could also maybe even see Valeria and Rowan switching spots, potentially. But outside of that, I think in terms of characters, I think I feel comfortable with this. So let me know how my opinions differ from yours, and let me know what you liked, what you didn't, and that should be that. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed this. If so, let me know, leave a like, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I will see you around. So thanks for watching. And until then, peace out.